that the next level isn't necessarily a cardio DVD. You know, we've got so many great cardio trainers at Beachbody. You know, my expertise is to help people, you know, improve their balance, their coordination, their stamina, their endurance through high-intensity exercise, through core exercise, through functional exercise, through exercises that involve brand-new pieces of equipment that we haven't introduced before. And that's basically what P90X2 is. You know, we've got plyocide in there, which is the new plyometric routine. We've got chest back in balance. We've got the new core routine. We've got the new ab ripper routine. But you won't see a Kempo routine, and you won't see martial arts. You won't even see a traditional cardiovascular routine. You know, we've got plyo in there, which you're soaking wet from. You got yoga, which you'll be soaking wet from. You'll be, we've got PAP lower, you know, which is going to feel like cardio, but it isn't. It's an interval exercise, in a series of interval exercises to help you jump higher and run faster, and also improve the knee joint and the hip joint while you're doing things that are extraordinary athletic. We assume that a vast majority of the people that buy P90X2 have done either even Power 90 for that matter. You cannot come into P90X2 out of shape. It's much like insanity. You know, you've got to have a solid base of fitness. And what it does is it there to make you lose 25 pounds? People will lose weight using P90X2. There's no question about it. But the main focus is to help people get strong and fast and stable and athletic, and to become more less vulnerable to injury as they go out in the world. I mean, I say that P90X2 is indoor training for the outside world, and it's just a blast. You know, there's going to be a lot of things there. There's a lot of learning curves, obviously, with some of these exercises. We're doing levers, which is a gymnastic pull-up. We're doing push-ups on 4 med balls. You know, both hands and both feet are on a med ball. So there's a learning curve, and that's the whole idea. You know, you don't get better at things that are easy when you don't get better by doing things that are relatively easy for you. You get better by doing things that are almost impossible. I mean, we even have a push-up called the impossible.
So let me, Tony, let me stop you for a second.
Yeah, go for it.
So we've got, you know, all of our coaches here, and as they go out and speak to new customers, positioning this pre-order of P90X2, my guess is the question will be this. Okay, so I've endured, I've been through P90X, and it challenged me, but I'm in decent shape. Will that qualify me for P90X2? You kind of touched on this. And what kind of additional results will I see from P90X2 that I don't see from P90X? So as they're trying to position the value benefits of this, you know, P90X2, you know, if you could say, you do need this in order to be ready for P90X2, and here's the market difference you'll be able to tell from P90X2. Does that question make sense?
I think so. I mean, I think what you're asking is, how do coaches tell folks who want to buy P90X2, if, you know, asking them if they're ready for it or not based on their experience with P90X? Is that what you're asking me?
Yeah, I think that's a good way to put it.
Well, you know, the one thing about P90X2, it's not P90X harder. It will be P90X different, and as a result of that, it will seem harder initially. You know, Steve Edwards and myself and Stephanie Saunders and Steve Holmson, you know, and Carl was in the mix when it came to trying to create a sequence of exercises so people could transition very well from P90X to P90X2. What we also made sure with P90X2 is, you know, like much like with P90X, there's a modified version of almost every exercise in P90X. And so in P90X2, we took the next step and we created not only the modified exercises, but also exercises for people that travel, because there's a lot of equipment required, not a lot, but there's brand new equipment required for P90X2, medicine balls, BOSU balls, not BOSU balls, I'm sorry, medicine balls, med balls, foam roller, and of course bands or weights. But for people who travel a lot, and especially a lot of coaches that are traveling around the country, we have there's one particular person in the DVD that is doing all modified versions. And for a lot of people who are starting out, they're not going to be able to do the push-ups on 4 med balls, and we understand that. So we're trying to show people the basic form of a particular exercise so they can advance properly through the program. Also, the neat thing about P90X2 is, and a lot of people are appreciative of this, it's a 5-day-a-week program, not a 6, partly because the routines are unique in the sense that they tax certain body parts so that you need an extra day off. Also, we're expecting people that on one of those 2 days off, is to go out into the world and kayak and mountain bike and hike and play tennis and do whatever it is that the exercises are showing you how to do better, if that makes sense. I think it's a pretty, you know, people are going to be at different fitness levels, obviously, but they certainly were when they bought P90X. You know, you've got people who are, professional athletes, collegiate athletes, soccer teams and football teams and baseball teams using P90X, people that were in peak condition that got in better shape as a result of using P90X. You've also got people like, you know, Jeremy Yost and Dallas Carter and Tommy Migrant that lost over, 100 pounds plus, who you would have thought would have never been able to do P90X. Maybe they should have started with something a little bit easier like Power 90 or something. But because of the way the program is set up, even people who have a lot of weight to lose can still manage to do it, you know, if they're smart and they're modifying. But with P90X2, you're going to need a certain base of fitness to be able to get going on that.
Okay.